Hello friends, I am NK Jain from Skill on Tech. Today I will share you a video about multi-stage boiler feed water pump with animation. In this video, I will explain about various components and internals of pump and functioning of pump. I will also explain how axial thrust is managed in the multi-stage pumps with balancing drum and thrust bearing. The video is taken from KSB. The boiler feed water pump is manufactured by various manufacturers. KSB is a proven manufacturer of boiler feed water pump. The KSB manufactured boiler feed water pumps are generally used in all industries. The pumps are very reliable. So let us see the animation. This is a boiler feed water pump, which is shown. This is a boiler feed water pump. You can see here, this is a suction of the pump and this is a discharge of the pump. We can see here at this side, coupling will be installed on the shaft and the suction is coming from this side here. The suction pipeline is designed in such a way and losses shall be bare minimum to maintain NPSH. This is a discharge pipeline. Velocity of fluid in the suction pipeline shall be 1 meter per second, not more than that. So we can see here all the individual parts of the feed water pump. Here you can see this is a suction, this is a suction nozzle, this is a casing of the pump, these are the stages, stage casing, this is a discharge pipeline, this is rotor, coupling will install here and this coupling will be connected with a prime mover motor, electric motor coupling, and these are the tie bolts. Now you can see the cross section of the pump. These are the impellers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is an 8 stage pump. In a multi stage pump, the suction pressure goes to the first stage and discharge of the first stage will become the suction of the second stage impeller here. Similarly, in further stages, discharge of the second stage will be suction of the third stage. And in the last stage, the discharge of this last stage impeller will be goes to discharge pipeline and delivered to the required or designated place. The optimum approach of flow due to free suction area is there. The area is manufactured in such a way that there should be a bare minimum losses in the suction. Now you can see this is a complete assembly of the pump. Now here you can see the suction water, boiler feed water is going inside of this suction passage. And then it will goes to this suction eye of this impeller. This is suction eye. And once this goes to the suction eye, boiler feed water, which is axially going to the suction eye of the impeller, is discharged radially. And then further it goes to the diffuser casing. And from diffuser casing, the kinetic energy of this water is converted into the pressure energy and the pressure energy will further goes into the suction of the second stage impeller eye. The impellers are used closed vanes, closed shroud impellers. The extremely low NPSH value due to axial inlet combined with a standardized suction impeller. So NPSH requirement is bare minimum in these kind of pumps. Smooth operation resulting from medium lubricated internal bearings, no auxiliary system necessary no maintenance. Now here you can see this is a impeller bearing ring clearance. So water which is passing through the clearance is going again back to the suction. Now you can see this is a throttle bush and this is a balancing drum. Here it is a mechanical seal provided along with the shaft in the stiffing box to minimize the leakage from the stiffing box, and further in the bearing housing the bearings will be provided. These pumps are matched with the customer requirement through various hydraulic options. Here you can see this is a rotor and all our impellers are keyed on the shaft with a key. This is a keyway which is shown. Now you can see the water is continuously going from one impeller to another impeller stage wise and going up to the last stage. Here you can see the impeller is mounted on the shaft. Axial thrust balancing device, combination of medium lubricated radial bearing and patented integrated thrust bearing. So these pumps are designed in such a way that only one radial bearing and one thrust bearing is required with the inclusion of balancing drum. So a radial bearing will be installed towards suction side and thrust bearing will be installed towards discharge side. Now you can see this is a flow path. From here suction is coming and this is going to the discharge through diffuser to the another impeller, and then finally it goes from discharge pipeline. Here you can see the discharge of the last stage impeller is passing. This high pressure boiler fluid water is coming into this throttle bush clearance and going here, and this is a balancing drum. So this pressure will act here in this direction here, and then it goes through this clearance to the balance chamber, and from balance chamber this is going again, and this balance chamber is connected again with the suction of the pump for balancing the pressure of balance chamber and suction pressure. So the pressure in the balance chamber is almost equal to or little higher than the suction pressure. Now here you can see the pressure distribution. All the discharge pressures of every stage will act in this direction. So you can see this P1 pressure is acting in this direction. This will also act in this direction. All the pressures of all 8 stages discharge pressure will act in this direction. And here you can see the yellow portion shows this is the discharge of second stage. This is the suction of third stage is acting in this direction. Similarly, the discharge of third stage will become the suction of fourth stage and act in this direction. And final stage pressure will be act here in this direction, which is shown as P5 on the balancing drum. And this balancing chamber pressure P6 will be act opposite, in the opposite direction here in the on the balance drum. So with this all the axial thrust is balanced. So the sigma ax, the axial thrust which is produced from all impellers will act in this direction as shown in the this red arrow FAX1. So all 8 impellers axial thrust will be act in this direction, and the last stage discharge pressure which throttled through throttle bush will come on the balance drum and will act in this direction here shown as F drum. Sudden change in operating condition increase hydraulic force at impeller. The rotor moves towards the suction side, the gap closes. Now you can see this is a here, this is a gap, and it will be closed if you will increase the operating, change the operating conditions. So now here you can see This balance drum is moving along with the shaft. So mechanical seal is provided as a standard, no cooling water required up to 140 degree centigrade. So this is a boiler feed water pump which is shown, and you can see the internals of all this, and this is a balance pipeline which is shown here. From balance chamber is connected to the suction of the pump. A smooth operation due to medium lubricated bearings. So as there is no much complex in the pump, so maintenance is very easy. No auxiliary system necessary. Easy to maintain. Matching customers' requirement through various hydraulic options are available. So KSB can make the pumps as per the requirement of the customers. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.